Very warm welcome again to all of you who are joining us at this moment for our third webinar, for our webinar series, Industrial Wireless Solutions. Today in our third webinar, we are focusing on applications and industries. And of course, we will present you many projects we have realized in the last years. So my name is Elena, and I will guide you through this webinar and also do the first part of it. And together with my colleagues, Didier and Suber, we will present you our content of this webinar today. So first of all, a few organizational topics. So also during the webinar, you're invited to send us your questions in the chat. Just send your questions to me at Elena Q&A. You will see my name when you open the window for all the people that are joining this webinar today. And of course, optionally, you can also later on talk to us. Therefore, you just need to raise your hand. You see this little symbol right next to your name, and then we can invite you to open your microphone and also speak to us. We are recording this webinar like all of our webinars, so we will upload this on our YouTube channel and also send everyone who registered for this webinar. So the content of this webinar today, a little bit more into detail. We will first of all see the applications and industries that we are in with our wireless solutions. We will take a deeper look into some projects that we have realized. There are many of them. Unfortunately, we cannot show all of them, because we could easily fill a full week with our project. And we will also later on see a live demo of our diagnostic. This will be shown to you by Didier, and we will also take a look into the success factors of implementation. And here specifically, we will introduce you how important antennas are and what to basically look into. Before we start, I would like to do a little survey. So I'm opening the survey now. You should see a window, and I'm inviting you to answer this question. Do you already have radio data transmission systems in use? So you should all see now the results. So we have almost 60% that are already customers. So thanks for joining us today. Then we have also 14% that use other systems and 33% that are not using radio data transmission systems at this moment in time. Okay, so I'm closing this one now. And I will directly start with our presentation. So as I already said, Schildknecht AG, a German company, has 30 plus years of wireless expertise. We were one of the first companies to start with wireless automation systems. First of all, there were still serial signals that we were transmitting, and we were also one of the first companies to start with wireless profibus. Therefore, we also have a patent and specialize in stable radio communication, because we know the most important thing for PLC communication is that you don't get unwanted bus errors, for example, due to radio interferences. So we are specializing on stabilizing exactly this. Yeah, there's many different industries. So we started with cranes for galvanizing plants. We are in intralogistics with HEVs. We are also in process industry, also building materials, what we are supplying with our systems, and also stage technology, classical mechanical engineering, like tooling machines, for example, or we're in the wastewater treatment plants. We do lift systems. You might have already seen one example of an inclined lift in the second webinar, and we're also in automotive. And now I would directly like to start and show you what kind of projects we are realizing. So it's basically simple cable replacements. We do retrofit a lot of slip rings, also still with Profibus. And we also focus on process automation. So we really help our customers to realize projects where different machines in the production need to communicate with each other. And of course, if they are flexibly roaming around and moving, then wireless is a good choice compared to a cable or any other technology. We are also focusing, of course, on diagnosis, and we will show you later why this is important and how this helps for wireless projects. And of course, wireless safety and redundant communication is done with our DATAEAGLE radio systems. The first project I have here today is a Stranding machine. So we are doing a retrofit here with wireless profibus in cable production. So basically, many of these Stranding machines are modernized. So the slip rings are replaced with wireless solutions. Of course, it's very important that the systems here are robust. So you see in the picture our DATAEAGLE Extreme in IP65, because this whole part here is turning with 400 RPM. So here at the where my mouse is basically, this is turning and this is basically wiring and making and producing the cables. So in the next picture, you also see the antennas. So of course, every project needs to have a good choice and technically a perfect choice for the omnidirectional antennas on both sides. So one is at the back of this plate here, and this is basically on the left side, the master antenna. So this machine is running since 2016. In the meanwhile, we have done many more machines like this in different countries. Yeah, Schaeffer Krantechnik, a company that is producing cranes, like you see these kind of overhead cranes, has been one of our first customers, and they mainly work with Siemens technology. So wireless Profibus, wireless Profinet, and also, of course, ProfiSafe. So the range of these indoor applications is up to 200 meters. Here we would, of course, always try to work with directional antennas when it comes to these kind of ranges. Since we've been working with Bluetooth technology, and whoever is interested in learning more about the differences of Bluetooth and probably Wi-Fi solutions can also probably has joined already our second webinar last Thursday, or can rewatch this again, that due to the frequency hopping, Bluetooth is much more stable against reflections that we are definitely having here, because there's a lot of steel and a lot of materials inside this production facility. And if we take a look into building materials, Bicotronic is a German customer, and they are definitely innovation leader in the field of control technology for concrete and bulk material industry. So they do these bucket conveyors, which you see here, one in yellow. There's also other options, which you then can see here. And they are basically producing the complete control technology here in these decentralized control cabinets, which you see here, like the big gray and black system. And from the very beginning, they were working with field bus technology, and of course, also Profibus and Profinet. And there's also a lot of ProfiSafe applications they have been realized so far. We work here with our DATAEAGLE 3712 for wireless ProfiSafe, and 4712, also multipoint for wireless Profinet ProfiSafe. One of these systems can normally have up to 15 of these decentralized bucket conveyors and also then control cabinets. And of course, the only real solution to realize these kind of projects are a wireless solution. So I would like to go to China for our next project. So here we have these tunnel boring machines. This is a very big one. So the diameter is here 18 meters. So we can, or they can easily build a 4-highway street in one drill, so to say. And the rest of the machine is almost 100 meters long, so where all the material then is transported over conveyor bands. And I'm going to switch to another picture so you can really see the dimensions here. with the people. So I was there by myself. And on the right side, you can see inside the cutting wheel. Basically, there's a lot of material, a lot of actuators, and also a lot of sensors. And these kind of sensors transmit, or we transmit these sensor signals for then adjusting the speed and the feet of this cutting wheel, which you can see here on the left picture. So the PLC is placed around 30 meters away from this cutting wheel. Yeah, then another customer of us is called AutoLift, and they do lifting equipment. So you can already hear it from the name. And these special projects are do the maintenance for the trains. So they have these, what you see in yellow here, these specialized lifting equipment to lift a complete train. And all of these yellow stamps, they are connected wirelessly and also synchronized. This is done with Profibus and ProfiSafe technology. And it's very important, since these yellow stamps are freely movable, that they are also not connected to each other with like a Profibus cable, because if you then have like a forklift driving underneath the train or next to it, or people moving from A to B, this is of course much safer and much more convenient as well to have this all wirelessly. And we have been doing many of these projects in the past 10 years to make sure that our trains all over the world are in good shape. So whoever joined our second webinar knows this project already. So inclined lifts is one of the specialties for us, because they have highest safety expectations regarding the control technology. So we are using our wireless Profibus ProfiSafe system, DATAEAGLE 3000, to do the communication between the cabins. And you see two of here, and to the central control station, which is up on the hill. This project is in Paris, and this lift is doing 500,000 trips per year up to Basilica Sacré-Cœur in Paris. And in the next picture, you will also see that we use directional antennas in between the central station and those two cabins. And for our next project, I would like to show you a video. So our customer is ATP Hydraulics, and they're supplying to ABC Rides in Switzerland. And together we do a lot in entertainment. And here you see the tourbillon, and the first tourbillon was set in Hong Kong. And there I would like to start this video, so this explains much better than I can do in words. Yeah, so if you take a look at this tourbillon, so this thrill ride, we are doing the wireless ProfiSafe communication here. So basically the positioning of these three rings, including the cabin, which you see here in pink, is done with a redundant wireless profi safe communication. The whole thrill ride is up to 20 meters high, and it's completely, of course, on performance level E certified. And we're responsible for the communication. And of course, it's very important that the communication is not interrupted by any other things that are happening on the 2.4 gigahertz band. We are, of course, also working with our Bluetooth technology here, DATAEAGLE 3000, that has our stabilization and our pre-processing to make sure that the communication is not interrupted. So if you are more interested about the safety applications, you may join our webinar on Thursday in 2 days. So then I'm moving over to mechanical engineering. And here we have a film cutting machine that is realized with wireless Profinet. On the left side, you see this big coil where you basically have the plastic that later on is cut into up to 22 smaller rolls of adhesive tape. In the next picture, you see how this then actually looks like. And of course, if there is a problem in the communication, then the plastic foil is basically rolling off and not again rolled up onto this smaller coils, basically. So we are controlling all of these arms, which you can see in the middle picture, but also on the right side. So where you see the red arrows, you see the drive for each and every of these arms. And on top, you see a DATAEAGLE Extreme Slave, a special version with an integrated antenna that is receiving the information from up to 10 masters. So the machine comes in different sizes, and this depends on how many arms you basically have. So the number of tapes that can be produced. And also these arms can be adjusted flexibly. And this is also done then with our radio communication. So it's very important that they have a stable system up and running, because in serious production, it's not very helpful if you have many bus errors and still standing machines. And before, they also were using a different wireless technology and they had some problems, but we say knock on wood, up till and until today, since they are using DATAEAGLE, they haven't faced any stillstands and problems. So now I would like to more into our, let's say, project business, where we really go into the detail with the customers and trying to optimizing their production facility. So on the right side in blue, you see an HEV that is feeding the machine with material. And our customer in Italy, System Ceramics, they produce ceramics. They requested to have communication between the machine and the HEV. So they needed to transmit some I/O signals depending on what material is coming, and wanted to have a bidirectional communication. So in the next picture, you see on the right side what we have installed on the AGV, and on the left side, you see what's installed in the machine. So on the right side, we have our DATAEAGLE Extreme I/O that have digital inputs and outputs, four of each. So first of all, when the AGV is coming, it's connecting with the machine, and the machine already knows what kind of AGV is coming, so it can connect via the specific MAC address of the Extreme I/O and can then basically start the communication. And on the left side, our DATAEAGLE 2730 compact gateways, they are communicating via EtherCAT with the PLC. So we also do these kind of projects, a little bit more, let's say, specialized, not the classical cable replacement. And we can do I/O to field bus communication, I/O to I/O, or also act like a field bus converter. What you see in the next project is an automotive project that we have realized in Portugal at Renault. And the plant in Portugal, in Aveiro, they are producing motor and gear parts. And here in the proof of concept scope, we were supplying 12 machines because every production line has 12 machines and they are placed around what you then see here on the right side, like the central cabinet that is connected to all of the machines. And on the left picture, you can take a deeper look into one part of that cabinet. And on the top, you see our DATAEAGLE. You see two gateways because we're working with Bluetooth low energy and we are connecting again to the DATAEAGLE Extreme IO. So what you've seen in the project before, every machine in total 12 has one Extreme IO and we can connect up to 8 Extreme IO or sensors to one central gateway. We're working on Profinet here. We're feeding the information that we receive from the machines and from the sensors to a local dashboard and also to a local condition monitoring system that has already been installed for the complete Renault plant. And we are supplying more and more of these production lines. So in the next picture, you also see these kind of tooling machines. So some of them are actually quite old, like really ancient tooling machines, still some of them working on Siemens S5 technology. And this is also why they wanted to install sensors. So they're installing temperature sensors to monitor temperature in the cabinet and also in the machine itself. And also the hydraulic pressure is monitored via analog sensors. So you see here, wherever there is this purple arrow on the backside of the machine, there is one of these Extreme IOs mounted. And on the top, you see three connected analog sensors, and they are delivering the values from the machine, and we then transmit them wirelessly. You see here on top of it, where you also see the LEDs, there we have placed a wireless module, and we are transmitting them then to the central gateway. They really wanted to have this wirelessly because they were not able to have additional cable or wiring because it was basically a retrofit solution. So it was installed after this whole production was set up. And now I would like to hand over to my colleague Didier. He will give you details about our next project and then also directly start introducing you the diagnostic with a live demo.
Thank you, Elena, and also from my side, thank you for joining to the webinar. Warm welcome. The project I would like to explain is the drilling ship made by Aker in Norway. So this was one of the most interesting projects we have done in the last past years, and it was also one with the highest recommendations to the wireless connection. As you can see, there is a driller on the top of the ship, and they are drilling for oil and gas in the bottom of the sea. On the next picture, you can see that on top of this driller, there's a rotating system which drills or is rotating the driller. And therefore, they use the wireless communication between the base station and the driller on the top. The highest recommendation comes first of all, because there's profi-safe communication, so it shouldn't interrupt because an interruption will cause a big problem on the ship. Additional recommendation was that it can be used in harsh environments, in Artex environment, so it needs to be ATEX approved. And additionally to that, they need additional ship approvals to use this material on a ship. So very high recommendations, and therefore they tested the complete system against a cable or versus a cable more than 1 year. If the cable is broken, they have a downtime of about 1 day. They need to replace the cable. They need to bring a new cable to the ship via a helicopter, the service technicians to the ship via a helicopter. The ship cannot produce anymore, cannot drill anymore. So the cost for 1 day shut off is about 600,000 euros. So very, very expensive if the cable gets broken. And therefore, they tested a wireless system against the cable. And as you can see on the next slide, they did that for more than 1 year or about 1 year. And they also used our diagnostic tool, our diagnostic information that is integrated in our wireless systems to check how the system works. As you can see in the picture, they had an overview of the response times. So most of the telegrams are responded in between of 40 up to 70, maybe 80 milliseconds. That was the response time most of the time. Then we have some around 100, 120 milliseconds and up to over 300 milliseconds. But for the complete test, they didn't realize the interruption of the PROFISAFE connection caused by the wireless system. You can see in the button that they are counting number of errors, 40 errors, and they told us that this was caused by shutting down the complete system, by powering off. So it was not caused by a radio interruption. In the end of the year, the wireless link was more reliable than the cable solution that was specially developed by LAP because the cable broke after about half a year. So the wireless system was more reliable and the wireless beats the wired link in this case. Yeah, the special diagnostic function is integrated in our device, as I said. And therefore, I would like to switch over to a short live demo to show you what you can see and what you can do with our diagnostic tool. Therefore, I would first of all like to show you our demo case for all those who didn't join the previous webinars. We have prepared a wireless PROFINET communication. So on the left side, you can see the PLC. On the right side, you can see the remote I/O, and you can see the data exchange by these flashing LEDs. And you can also see the wireless link in between. We also explained in the previous webinars our pre-processing unit that is working inside of the devices. And to show you how this works, I will shortly interrupt the connection with a radio disturber. And you should take a look at the flashing LEDs. What happens if a radio interruption will be there? So please check the LEDs and I will start disturbing now. And once again. And once again. So what you have seen is that the communication is interrupted for a short period of time. The flashing LEDs stopped, but started immediately after I switched off the disturber. And this is what you will get in the end if you install the system in a real industrial environment. You will get short interruptions of the communication. And to visualize it or to analyze these interruptions, we have integrated this diagnostic function into our devices. And therefore, I will start sharing my screen and show you how the diagnostic tool looks like. So every PROFIBUS and PROFINET and also the open safety systems are equipped with this diagnostic tool. So in this case, we are reading out the diagnostic information via the Ethernet interface, but you can also integrate these kind of information into your PLC and visualize it via the HMI, or you can also use it for adapt the speed of a crane, for example, by using the diagnostic information. I don't want to go into deep detail of each and every information here. We have some basic information like some counters, the software version, DATAEAGLE type, and so on. We can also show what kind of PROFINET devices the master has found and integrated. So in this case, it's a more electronic I/O station for safety communication. This is the PROFINET name for it. You can see the IP address and also the state machine, which means we can also see if there's a misconfiguration of the device. Now it's in data exchange mode. This 11 means data exchange mode. But if this is counting up and down all the times, so then we can see that there's a misconfiguration. But in principle, the device is there and is also answering. We You can see the Profinet requests and the Profinet responses from the device. So everything runs fine. And yeah, you can see that via the diagnostic information. Two of the most interesting information from the diagnostic tool is the data exchange time and also the retries, which means the master needs to resend a telegram over the wireless link. Because of our pre-processing unit, the application and the customer will not recognize that because he didn't get bus error state, but the system needs to resend some telegrams. And to see that more detailed, I will deactivate all the other information so we get a better update time of these two parameters. So I will switch off all the other information. Sorry, this one and this one. So now we have a very fast update time of the data exchange time and also of the retries. What you can see over here, the data exchange time is around 40-50 milliseconds, and we have one retry measured in since startup. If I now activate the radio disturber once again, you will see that the data exchange time will be much more higher. I will start disturbing now, and please take a look on this data exchange time. Once again. Well, you couldn't see that. Update time is still too slow. So normally you should see that the update time is about 200, 300 milliseconds or more.
Yeah, it went up. We quickly saw it.
Oh, okay.
Up to 1,000 milliseconds.
Okay, then it was just on my screen that didn't
at least updated. I saw it. I don't know.
Okay, perfect. If you saw that and I just don't see it, everything is okay. What you can also see is that the radio retries are going up, counting up. So we had one retry before, and now we are measured 5 retries in the meantime because of the radio disturber, of course. But these parameters are very interesting for continuous checking via the PLC or via a remote access, because you can see that something in the radio setup changed. Maybe the antenna is getting worse. It runs full of water, for example, or somebody destroyed the antenna cable, or maybe the device is going defect. So you will first of all see that in the radio retries. They are counting up faster than before, and this is an indication that something changed and maybe you need to have a look at the complete system and check what's happening over here. You can act before there's a complete interruption of the wireless link. So this is one of the main functionalities and very important to integrate that into your project, because you get an indication of how good the system is working. Yeah, another point for good working wireless solutions are the antennas. And therefore, I will hand over to my colleague Suvayer, who will give you some insights about what is an antenna, how an antenna works, and what we recommend to use in which application.
All right. Thank you very much today. All right. Okay. That was a really interesting demonstration with the diagnostics. And now that we have gone through the different applications, we might have seen in some of the applications that we have mentioned the kind of antennas that we have used. So also in our webinar one, we did mention a few of our success factors for any wireless project. And here is one of the most important success factors that we'd like to go a bit into detail so that we understand how to use the antennas and how to get the most out of it. So to start off with how to mount the antennas, we first need to understand the two widely used kinds of antennas. The first one over here on the left is the omnidirectional antenna, and on the right is the directional antenna. And what you see here is a characteristic image of the radiation. It's not the antenna itself. And the antenna for the omnidirectional type, it transmits, it radiates the signals in 360 degrees on a horizontal plane. So that's why you see like a donut shape over here. So it's transmitting on the X and Y axis, and you've got a 360 degree transmission. And for the directional antenna, what it's doing over here is that it's taking all of that signal and it's directing only one direction. So in this case, you see somewhat like a balloon, it's transmitting only in the X axis, not in the Y and the Z axis. So with this, you can think of a torch, for example. A torch is directing all the light in one direction, so you get a bit further away with the light. So similarly, with directional antennas, you can transmit a bit further that as compared to the omnidirectional antennas. Now, the different ways you can use the antennas, different ways you can apply them, implement them into your application is using directional antenna on the sender and on the receiver side. So this type of setup is recommended if you have the sender and the receiver not in motion. They both are stationary. In this case, you can use directional antennas. And say the sender or the receiver or both of them are in linear motion. They are moving towards each other, away from each other, or they're moving parallel to each other, but in such a way that the antennas, they can transmit all the signals to the other one. So in this case as well, we recommend using directional antennas. Another kind of application would be where we use two omnidirectional antennas. In this case, say the sender or the receiver here is in motion, it's also rotating, so you can't actually direct, you can't fix a directional antenna and direct it in only one direction, since the slave or the master would be rotating. So one example could be AGVs, where the vehicles are in motion, they're moving, they're turning right. Now, in this case, you need to still have that connection with the master, so that's why omnidirectional antennas are recommended in this case. A third case would be a combination of both of them. You can combine the directional antenna and the omnidirectional antenna. Say the master is stationary and the motion of the AGV, for this instance, is within the reach of the directional antenna. So you can use the directional antenna on the master side and omnidirectional antenna on the slave side, and you can have a really good robust radio connection here. We have explained a lot of concepts regarding antennas in detail in our white paper, Antenna 101. You can find these images, you can find these explanations and a bit more in our white paper. And you can download that on www.schildknecht.ag/en/antenna-technology. A few other points regarding the alignment, the directional antennas over here on the left, you see, they need to be aligned in such a way that the transmission from the sender should reach the receiver. So in a way to say that they should be able to see each other. So the opening angle would be important here to consider. So if you have an opening angle of say 55 degrees, so the sender should be set within 55 degrees of the receiver. So in this case, you have direct connection between the two antennas, and then they can communicate with each other without any problem. Now, another application here with the omnidirectional antenna, this is one of our special antennas. You can see that it's transmitting in 360 degrees on a horizontal plane, and it has a tilt of 20 degrees and 40 degrees opening angle. What this means is that on a vertical plane, the opening angle is 40 degrees, and it is directed upwards, so it's tilted 20 degrees. So in case you have a master antenna mounted on an offset, it's on a roof, for example, and the slave antenna is somewhere on the ground level. In this case, you can say with a 20 degree tilt and a 40 degrees opening angle, you can connect both of them. This kind of antenna can be used in such applications with offsets. And another important point that you might have seen also in our application examples is that there needs to be a line of sight between the sender and the receiver. This means that the master antenna and the slave antenna, they should be able to see each other. Now, this does not mean that if something comes in between that the entire communication is broken, but it means that it depends on what comes in between that the communication gets broken. So we normally recommend with a clear line of sight, you get a better connection, a robust connection, and you don't get any disturbances or interferences in. And taking that point a bit further, it's pretty logical to then mount the antenna outside the cabinet. So you have to pull the antenna out, whereas you install the DATAEAGLE device in the cabinet. And with this, you get a clear line of sight. But there are cases where you can still mount the antenna within the cabinet in case the cabinet is made out of synthetic materials such as plastic. So in this case, the antenna signal is not dampened much, but it's still, again, recommended always to pull the antenna out of the cabinet and you get a better line of sight, better connection. Another few basics regarding antenna mounting. Over here, you see the antennas on the master and the slave, they shouldn't be mounted in such a way like they shouldn't be in perpendicular motion, because if you remember the 3D diagram that I showed you, that you've got a donut shape radiation characteristics. So this antenna would be transmitting in this direction in 360 degrees, and this direction antenna would be transmitting in this direction 360 degrees. So it will be difficult for them to connect. So that's why that won't be possible. It won't be wise to do so. Similarly, this is another case where this direction, the antenna is transmitting this direction and this one in another direction. And they both are parallel in transmission. They're not connecting with each other. So over here, you see they both are parallelly mounted. So they are transmitting in the same plane. So they're connecting with each other. Over here, they're mounted in an opposite direction, but still the transmission is in the same plane. So it still functions in this case. Another important point here is also with the directional and the omnidirectional antenna. The directional antenna on the wall is recommended as opposed to omnidirectional antenna on the wall, because like if you see over here with the omnidirectional antenna, you've got the transmission in 360 degrees and there is some transmission that's being, some rays that are being reflected. Now this could cause some negative effect on the receiver's end. So that's why it's recommended if you are mounting it on a wall, it's recommended to use a directional antenna. And if you want to use an omnidirectional antenna, then you can do on a freestanding mast where the omnidirectional antenna is then mounted around the tip so that you get a 360 degrees transmission. So with that, I come to the end with the antenna mounting, and I hope it's pretty much clear with how we mount the antennas and how to get a good connection. And I'd like to hand it over now to Elena for the ending of this webinar. Thank you.
Yes, super. Thank you very much. Thanks for the details about the diagnostics and also the antennas from my colleagues Didier and Super. So we would like to close this webinar now. So first of all, we have our last webinar on Thursday in 2 days. It's about wireless safety all into detail. So if you haven't registered yet and you are interested in this topic, you can still register for it. We will upload all our videos on our YouTube channel and also send you the videos with the link to our website where we are uploading them. Then we have also prepared a special thing for you. So on the slide, exactly, we will be happy to give you a free online consultation with one of us about your project. If you have some questions, just send us an email and we will be happy to have an appointment here with you. You also still have the chance to get our DATAEAGLE as a test system. The test system will be a period of 8 weeks and this will, of course, be free of charge so you can test live on site. If you don't have experience with DATAEAGLE or if you don't have experience in general, you can also, of course, we would help you to install the diagnostic if you really would like to take a deeper look into it. So just get in touch with us, send us an email at sales@schildknecht.ag. So now I would like to go to the Q&A round. I'm also receiving already questions. It seems like you already have found a way to send me a message.